Okay, I want to do a little video on the shotgun here. I've had this for like a dozen years or so. I think I probably haven't fired it in a decade or something, but I got a bunch of shooting videos from, like 12 years ago or something like that. I had a review of it that I did years ago, so look at that if you're interested. But I'll do a little better video here. Got the new camera, so we'll a little bit of detail. It's a nice old shotgun. This is 16 gauge. It's made in Belgium. I got this at Tradex, like, as I said, like 12 years ago. I think it might be 2.5 inch chambers, but I think they might have been cut out. Because I have shot 2 3/4 out of it, and it didn't seem to cause any excessive recoil or any other kind of problem. It's a bit. The action's not super tight, but that was like that when I got it, and I think it's only black powder proofed. You can watch the older video. I think I have go through a bit more of the details, or that I knew at the time, but because I tried to figure out when it was made, and I think it's by the proof marks. I think it's like pre-1925, but I think there's a some of the proof marks, they use them for certain years, so they're, it could be like 1900, it could be, whatever. But it's, I don't think it was a super expensive shotgun when it was made, but it was, it's decent. And a lot of these old Belgian ones, they get abused so bad that kind of gave them a bad name. But, you see, it's got like a beech stock, see, it's got that weird kind of cross grain thing going on. But it's a decent looking piece of wood. It's got back action locks, your double triggers. There's not a whole lot of markings on it. It has Acer Fine, so that's like fine steel written on it. And then it's full choke written on this side. The other one, the other barrel, I think is basically open, but when you measure the bore diameters, they're like the full choke side is it's like bigger than it should be, but I think it's because I think the bore is like oversized, and then there's still restriction at the end, but it starts out bigger, but then it ends up being bigger than it should be, kind of deal. And like this side, I think it's closer to 68 or something, if I remember right. But because 16 gauge should be like 662 or somewhere around there, but this side's way over that, so. But it doesn't really matter too much with a shotgun, because if it's bigger, but then it still constricts, it still chokes it, so it's like whatever. But so you got your top opening lever. This one doesn't have a crossbar or anything. We'll take the barrels off and see if we can look at some of the markings. We got a bit of a cheek piece here, and looks like it was nailed to something for some weird reason one time. Swivel here. It's got 29.5 inch barrels, or I guess that's like 75 centimeters, apparently. So. But she's in pretty good shape. The bluing isn't terrible on the barrels. There is a, I think there's a dent. Yeah, a bit of a dent there. And a bit of a nick in the barrel there. But doesn't hurt the running on any. Pretty good looking shotgun. Got a steel butt plate, which I like. And a lot of them have plastic and stuff. I don't really, not a big fan of it, or hard rubber, I think it is. But handguard just pops off. See, it still has a bit of case hardening apparent on here, but it's not. There's none left on the action itself. Got your lug there. Let's see if we can get this to open up here. So you can see it's only a single latch. You can see the Belgian proof marks there. It's got the little Liege tower. And the letter with the crown, I think that's an inspector code. They had date codes as well. I think I confused for inspector's codes or something in the past. But there is stuff online that tells you what the different date codes usually are. There's some serial numbers and some proof marks and stuff. So you got, see the choke. Let's see, that's 16. Yeah, I don't know what that 16 something over 17. So 17 millimeter must be bore diameter and 16 gauge, I guess. Then you got 17 over 17, so that must be a cylinder. So you got V with a star, that little Liege tower, 16 gauge chamber, and then the Liege, and same on this. No, that's an AV, is it? Maybe? I don't know. But I think those are either date or letter codes or something like that, but or just inspector's marks, but. So, it doesn't actually show the chamber dimensions. There's another one there, see, like a backwards P. And these are like initial proofs or something, I think, that weird symbol. But there's good websites that explain all this stuff. So, you can see the locks here. You can probably see here the choke side, and then the other one's a little bit thicker. But bores are pretty decent on it. It's got a little bit of pitting. I don't know if you can see it or not. Yeah, you can see a little bit of crud in there, but it is pretty old. It could be 100 years old or more. So, but anyway, so there's a few proof marks on there anyway. It doesn't really say if it's 2.5. I have fired 2.75 in it, so it's not really. I think it's the longer chamber. Pretty nice anyway, and it's sort of a dimensional action on it, like a lot of 16 gauges now, they put like a, or the newer stuff, they put like a 12 gauge action and they just put the 16 barrel on it, where these are actually dimensional, so they're a lot nicer, lighter and everything. But I should load up some black powder loads or Pyrodex loads for it and drag it out in the woods a little bit. But I don't think it cost me a whole lot when I bought it. I think it was like a $200 special or something. So, but anyway, so those proof marks show up pretty good. So a little bit of scroll work and stuff here. So you got your rib here, has wavy lines on it to cut down glare. So, but yeah, these old guns are actually, I don't think they were super expensive, but they were actually fairly well put together. And I guess when you have back action locks, it does make this smaller because there's nothing. But there's nothing inside of it, so that does help. But they got nice, you know, nice thin stock and everything, not chunky and terrible or anything. So, anyway, it's just a little better-ish video on the old Belgian 16. And, thanks for watching, guys, and, we will talk to you later.